Hello student, today we are going to continue our third chapter, human reproduction. Student, in my previous video we have discussed about all pre-fertilization events in human reproductive process. Today we are going to discuss the next topic, fertilization. Student, you all know that fertilization is a fusion of male and female gametes. And in humans, the male gamete is sperm and the female gamete is ovum. So, what is fertilization? Fusion of sperm and ovum. Here, there is a question that where the fertilization occur. You all know that fertilizations occur in fallopian tube. But in which region of fallopian tube? Because we read that fallopian tube have three regions: stomus, ampulla, infundibulum. So, in fallopian tube, in which region the fertilization is occur? Then you say that fertilization is occur in the ampulla region of fallopian tube. Actually, student, you see here you see, student, that egg is released from the ovary and reach into the ampulla region, and we know that sperm is motile. So the motile sperms move through the cervix, enter the uterus, and then reach in ampulla region. Actually, student, it is insemination when the discharge of the semen by the penis in the female vagina close to the cervix during coitus. We call it insemination. Okay. And always remember one thing, that fertilization can only occur if the ovum and sperms are transported simultaneously to the ampulla region. This is the reason that all the copulations do not lead to fertilization and pregnancy. I hope you understand. How fusion occur between sperm and ovum? Student, we read that fertilization is a fusion of sperm and ovum. But how can sperm fuse with the ovum? We already read the structure of sperm and ovum. The first one is, sperm come in a contact with zona pellucida. What is zona pellucida? The outer membrane of ovum. So sperm come in a contact with zona pellucida layer of ovum and induce changes in the membrane which block the entry of other sperm. Okay, when the sperm come in a contact with zona pellucida layer, which is the outer layer of ovum, it induce changes in a membrane so that what happened? It block the entry of other sperm. And you know that sperm have head, middle part and tail. In a head part, acrosomes is present. Acrosomes of the sperm produce enzymes, and these enzymes help the sperm to burrow into the ovum cytoplasm. Student, here in this picture you can see that this is the sperm and it is the head part, acrosome. When it come in a contact with zona pellucida, it induce some enzymes. Okay, firstly, when it come in a contact with the zona pellucida, it induce change into the membrane which block the entry of other sperm. Then what happened? It secrete enzymes, and this secretion of the acrosomal help the sperm enter into the cytoplasm of the ovum. Okay, this enzymes help the sperm enter into the cytoplasm of ovum, and it this inducing part, this enzymes actually help in completion of meiosis division of the secondary oocyte. We read that when egg is released, it is in the secondary oocyte phase. That means meiosis is not completed. at the time. When the ovum is released from the ovary, it is secondary oocyte, and the secondary oocyte, the secondary meiosis division result in the formation of secondary polar bodies and a haploid ovum. And student, after that, the haploid nucleus of the sperm and the ovum fuse together, form diploid zygote. Now, what is the result of fertilization? Very clear. Fertilization lead to the formation of single cell zygote, and zygote undergo repeated division. Which division? Mitosis division, because zygote is diploid. And then embryo descended into uterus in 4 to 5 days. So student, in my next video, we discussed about implantation.